On June 30th, 2020, the state of Mississippi voted to abolish their flag. A replacement was set to be designed and adopted by December 2020, so for a six-month period, Mississippi was in flag limbo. The flag was put to a vote of change, with the primary reason being the use of the Confederate symbol. The Dixie flag, or Southern Cross respectively, is widely recognized today as the flag of the rebellious Confederate States of America. Except, this flag was never officially used or adopted as the national flag by the Confederate government. In November of 1860, after the Republican Party won the election with Abraham Lincoln, South Carolina said, "How about no?" and on December 20th, 1860, officially sent the United States its letter of resignation. Quickly followed by Mississippi, Florida, Alabama, Georgia, Louisiana, Confederate states founded, Texas, Virginia, Arkansas, North Carolina, and lastly Tennessee. Before any flag was officially adopted or government organized, Mississippi flew the Bonnie Blue from its capital as a symbol of independence. While the name Bonnie Blue originates in 1861, this flag was originally created and officially adopted by the Republic of West Florida, whom in 1810 declared their independence from Spanish Florida. Seems to be a trend. America said no and eventually took control of the territory, but the Bonnie Blue lived on. March 4th, 1861, the first official national flag of the Confederate States of America was adopted, the Stars and Bars. However, this flag was not popular among the Southerners because it looked quite similar to the very same Union they were breaking from. This similarity especially caused confusion among the battalions, where amongst all the chaos, it was difficult to quickly determine who was who. Consequently, many battalions chose to use their own battle flag, most famously the Army of Northern Virginia, commanded by Robert E. Lee. Look familiar? 2 years later, the Confederate government said, "Let's try this again," and on May 1st, 1863, adopted the second national flag of the Confederate States of America, the Stainless Banner, sporting the popular battle flag on a white background, no longer similar to the United States, but now looking quite surrenderish with all the white. The battalions didn't use it. So, another 2 years later, the Confederate government said, "Okay, let's try this again, one last time for reals," and on May 4th, 1865, adopted the third national flag of the Confederate States of America, the Blood-Stained Banner. However, this flag barely got to spread its wings when on April 9th, 1865, the Confederacy adopted the white flag. They surrendered to the United States. For nearly a century after the war ended, neither the battle flag nor the national flag saw much use. It wasn't until 1948 when the Dixiecrats, a splinter political third party, made a bid for president and used the battle flag to represent their movement. From this point on, the association started to take root, and the Dixie flag would continue to see more use throughout the civil rights era. As a result, this flag alone in its current variant is wrongfully recognized today as the Confederate flag, despite never being historically used at any point by the Confederate government proper. This brings us back to Mississippi. No longer official, this flag, with several versions, was adopted in 1894 and has been subject to many attempts at changing during the 21st century, all of which has failed up until now. In the spirit of removing Confederate symbols, I must bring attention to Georgia, which is literally just the first national flag, and since this flag isn't widely recognized, I don't think Georgians will be replacing it anytime soon.